I've not been shipped shoes like this before. Alright, so today, looks like we have a little problem. I was shipped shoes like this again, as we can see. And they're dirty, holy shit. They're literally dirty. Well, let's talk about it and why I keep getting shoes like this.
All right, so a lot of you guys are probably wondering, this is the second time this has happened to me. Why is this happening to me? Why do I keep getting shoes without boxes? Well, pretty much boxes, but they're unassembled. And today I wanted to, I guess, educate you guys. Not that you guys need education or anything like that, but something that I've been doing lately, where these shoes have been coming from and why these are in here. Obviously, it's a safe shipping. You guys all know that, like, when you ship like this, you probably save like $1,000. But these are actually all coming from China. And you might be wondering, are they fake? They're not fake.
There are different Nikes. There's Nike China,
Nike Australia, Nike US, Nike Canada, a bunch of different Nikes all over the world. For a while, I mean, for the most part, for most shoes, shoes in China, like Nike China, go for shoes in Nike China basically go for a lot cheaper, $30 to $40 cheaper market than they do in the States.
Hold or sell? What do you guys think? It's actually a pretty nice colorway. Looks really nice. Looks like a low top, almost obsidian one, but more powder, you know, blue and all that. I gotta go to the other side of Seattle. My charger's there. I'm not sure if you guys can see, but in the back, I have the linens in the back. And I also need to talk to you guys about like different shipping methods. Once I get the charger, I'm gonna go back home, take all these out, and then explain to you guys the cheap way to get shoes from overseas, like very discounted. People try and gatekeep it now, but I'm not gonna gatekeep it.
Only water I drink is sparkling water.
The two. Let's go. All right, so this is how it looks. Not the greatest packaging job, but it'll do. Here are all the pairs from the last clip that we had. You guys all know I had long hair. Like, now I have pretty short hair, but why did no one tell me to cut my long hair when I had long hair? Like, it was hideous. It was so ugly. And I don't know why you guys let it slide, but next time, if I ever come out looking like that, don't let it slide. The linens, right? As I was talking about, none of these are from the US. The amount of time, like, it took me so much time to fold it, but as we can see, there is a China label. These are not from the States, so they also don't have like a little, you guys know the little bar, like the thing that goes right here, the retail. I was originally supposed to get a lot more than this. It was closer to 150 pairs. The guy who I bought them from was like, low-key sus. I didn't find out that he was a semi-scammer until after he shipped it to me. I paid him for over 100 pairs. And then in the middle of it, he's like, oh yeah, by the way, I'm gonna ship you them, you know, with boxes all messed up and all that. So that was the first kind of mess up. And the second one was he didn't even fulfill 50 pairs. After it was over 100, he was like, oh, I'll only give you 50. Didn't even get me 50 pairs. Maybe this is like 40. And then also, a lot of the pairs had like, I don't know, like small little flaws and stuff like that. Like majority of them had small flaws, but they're all different. I would say that's like the biggest con when you're buying from a different country because like I said, this is from China. You just don't know what can happen. But like I said, the shipping, you do get pairs cheaper. And you guys are probably wondering, what am I gonna do with these? I'm gonna hold these till about Christmas and move them for over 200. One thing I do wanna talk to you guys about, since I feel like a lot of people are gatekeeping. So there's an app called Sneaker Dunk. You can get shoes for pretty cheap because all these are coming from, I think, Japan or like some Asia countries. $235. Shipping's obviously, you know, a little bit more costly, but as we can see, Gym Red, $114. So you can get pairs here for very, very, very cheap. Obviously, you know, you can't buy them in bulk. You can buy them in singles. And basically, I've known about this app for a minute. I just know that you can get shoes on here for cheap from other countries. And that's literally the whole point of this video and the point of the other videos that come shipped with like boxes open and all that. If you follow me, you probably pay resale for the shoes that you buy. I've never paid retail for a pair. And so our biggest thing is like, how can we get a shoe for cheap enough to make a profit on it? Whereas most people are going for like retail. But one thing I think a lot of people don't understand is that you can only get so many pairs for retail. And even if you do, most of the time people don't even hit. And so that's why so many people struggle when reselling, is because they try and get everything for retail and it doesn't work. Like literally every single person that I help with reselling, they all make anywhere from $5,000 to $15,000 without touching a single shoe for retail. You can ask any like really high profiting reseller. Typically, they're not getting stuff for retail. They're getting stuff for resell because that's how you make more money. And also, if you guys want more help on how to do that, I would highly suggest following my Instagram because I have more information there. But point is, this is a place, you know, you can get stuff for cheaper. That's also another reason why I buy off StockX. These honestly kind of look like a low top Obsidian, but I could easily see these hitting 200 without a doubt. One more thing I also want to add is if you guys are bulk shippers, or if you know in the future you want to ship bulk, you know, you could do what they do and ship them individually in big boxes. I personally wouldn't do that because it just takes a long time to take them all out, and I know it's a headache for most buyers. But again, you could do that. Ways you can find sellers in Asia who will ship you stuff for cheaper. Honestly, I would highly recommend Instagram, but be careful. Try not to find people who are like scammers. One thing I do want to do though is I do want to give away, because I don't sell this book anymore because there's a lot of information in there, but I do want to give away a copy to one of you guys for free. Matter of fact, I'll give away 3 copies because I feel like one is not enough. So 3 copies of my book, Art of the Hold. Honestly, probably the best book you can read, you know, this upcoming holiday season. So right now would be the time to actually buy stuff to hold. And it's crazy, like there's a lot of information here, but I'll give away 3. Rules for the giveaway: like this video and then follow my Instagram at sneakerinvest, and I'm gonna announce the winners on there. It's funny because like I don't even sell it. I don't sell it. It's like when people see me in person or something like that, I usually have like a copy, so I just give it away for free. But other than that, it's like I feel like selling it just defeats the purpose for me, because my whole thing is literally like my methods are in that book. So it's like, why would I sell something for whatever amount and give away everything? I'd rather not even sell it. It's like priceless to me. I'd rather just give it away for free. You're gonna literally, it's all gonna fall because of you.
It's not.
Why are you so short? Why are you, what are you?